Dear friends, regarding that judgment of Honorable NCLAT in disqualifying the person proposed by the financial creditor, it's going to have a serious implications and it's going to open Pandora box. And in the past two videos, I'm of the opinion that the judgment is not maintainable before the Honorable Supreme Court. I'm sure this will be challenged before Supreme Court because a large number of RPs are retired bank employees and banks also feel comfortable with them. And as already explained that Supreme Court as mentioned clearly that there is no place for equity. So some first point is we go by the judgment. The judgment, there is nothing to show that the resolution professional is in a quasi-judicial acts like a quasi-judicial function, does it? Only those tribunals or anybody acting judicially are subject to the principles of natural justice. So this was not discussed because even in the judgment order, they only decided there is a bias and how the bias has to be looked in. Now, whether the bias, the resolution professional, what is that resolution professional for? Let us see what the honorable judgments of various different judgments. In the case of Swiss Ribbons Limited versus Union of India, the Supreme Court observed that resolution professional is only a facilitator of the resolution process. He cannot act without the approval of a committee of creditors. So the point is very clear. So where does that bias come in? This judgment of Supreme Court very clearly lays down that he is only a facilitator and all his decisions are subject to the approval of the CoC. Section 28 of the code, if you take, there are duties given what should be taken with CoC's approval, normal duties. But then these are the duties to be performed by them. And suppose if the resolution professional takes a stand independent of the CoC, they will remove him. See, the appointment of resolution professional or PIRP, if you take, they are totally in the control of CoC, financial creditors. The first step is the act itself encourages the financial applicant to file Form 2, along with the take the consent of some resolution professional and then file the petition. That means this man is given, the financial creditor is given the empowered to choose the person who likes. So the act would have envisaged that he will, if I am going to take somebody, I am going to fix his remuneration. Remuneration also, NCLAT also decided that the committee of creditors will approve. In case committee of creditors doesn't approve, the excess amount should be paid by the applicant, whether it is operational creditor or financial creditor. Therefore, the intention of legislature is very clear that there is no such powers given to resolution professional to do these things. Section 28 very clearly says. And now we will see what are the other judgments we have. Adjudicating authority. In the case of ARC, Shivam Waters, here they have said only the resolution professional should get cooperation from all. But Honorable Supreme Court, again in Sasidhar versus IOB, very clearly said and reiterated it in the SR Steel's case, Satish Gupta, that the commercial wisdom of the Committee of Creditors is not justiciable. That also, whether that is correct or not, that is not to be considered. So today the law of the land is the judgment of the Committee of Creditors is not justiciable. So the object of CIRP is to keep it as a going concern, and then by keeping it as a going concern, they will be able to get a resolution applicant, and that proposal will be decided by COC. So therefore, a resolution profession appointment also will fall under the commercial wisdom of the Committee of Creditors, because once the IRP tenure is 30 days and his duty is only to collate the claims and take custody of the assets and keep the asset as a going concern. Once he forms the Committee of Creditors, then these people will come into the picture and then decide. And Act gives sweeping powers under Section 27. Section 22 of the code, either IRP can be allowed to continue as RP or remove that fellow, because there is no removal, his period is over and a new person is appointed, and that is up to the COC. Any number of times they can remove the RP. They never said that RP must be removed after giving reasons. Just 66% vote is there, RP is removed. So the legislature so far has no intention to give any independent position to RP. This is the law. Even though this Dinal Charles case, Bharati Defense, there is an accusation on the RP, Mr. Dinal Shah, that he sided, had a conflict of interest with the financial creditor, the Edelweiss. Then the NCLT took the decision, NCLT, that it is for the disciplinary committee of IBBI to look into this matter. So even in the thing they said, Swiss Ribbon's case, or in the case of SR Steel, are numerous such judgments. What is the RP role? They have defined. That is, this man has to do, compliances are properly done. And it is for the COC to take a decision in its best interest. Therefore, there is no place in the Act which says that he is exercising quasi judicial function, because they said actual bias versus real bias. That is the basis on which the decision was taken. Hence, this is decision is not maintained. But friends, if you see the judgment of Honorable Adjudicating Authority VP Singh, beautifully he analyzed Bharati Defense. But the problem is, naturally, this is a problem that should be handled by IBBI. Now, what is that IBBI should do and what is that they are not doing? I will talk. So, dear friends, now this video, we would like to request the IBBI first implead into the, once they appeal, that they should implead, because this is a matter which is affecting the entire the ecosystem of IBB, this IBC code. Honorable Chairman, he said, if you see that journey, that one, this thing, Journey of Hope or something, he has written. When you wanted to start with the IBC, he says that many people raise the issue of the ecosystem is not there. The most important person is the RP, and they have not developed. And in the answer, he said, we have developed 2,800 RPs. In the ecosystem is developed. But you mean to say, passing this exam and then throwing them to defend themselves, is it called creating an ecosystem? Needs to be discussed. Now, what were they? What is the adjudicating authorities? Because they are daily, day in and day out, they are seeing. And if you, there is, we need a data first. We have 2,000-3,000 RPs are there. And what is the type of RPs? Most of them are retired employees. Then if you take, for example, banks, large number of bankers who are retiring, chief managers, AGMs, chief general manager also, is becoming the this. And bankers are also giving. Actually, the chief general manager may be a lender. Then he may be very capable, may not be, I don't know. And but then the bankers are the main people. We lost 7 lakh crores. These are the money we have, the public sector bankers. So what is the yardsticks they should apply? And you are giving entire power of appointing them, removing them to them only. So why that complete losses, liquidation? The objects are not being achieved. So there is a need for relook at it. Till now they have not done anything. IBBA have not published any data. Do they have a data? How many of the retired RPs, 2,800 of these, how many of them are retired bank managers? And that is those people are there in that, and that is those people, bank retired managers or old people, 60, 70. But here the crux of the IBBI wants a person who can run the entity as a going concern. Again, out of this 2,800, how many of them have not done any work? Small works, you know. You get a company where there is nothing in the company, just have to close. Even they don't have money for liquidation costs. Such companies, what experience you will gain? And where is the, see, suppose if anybody gets a doubt, they should be able to ask the IBBI. There should be knowledge, web should be there for them to get advices. That is also not being done. And the recently one judgment, the tribunal judgment, they said that this man, committee of creditors approved what this man has to do. These people said you should be independent. Where is the scope for him? And then find him 6 months. Nobody, they should challenge in Supreme Court and tell them these people doing no work. How can you be independent here? You have not addressed that. Can you be independent? Can a chartered account, the RP take a stand? Irrespective of them, they will remove him. Understand? So the law is not giving any opportunity for proper functioning. And CIRP, you borrow, pledge, mortgage. Who will mortgage an asset company which is dead? Nobody will come. Even they have assets, mortgaging is a long process. The bankers have all the documents with them. They will not give. So you make the bankers responsible. Even in Swiss Rebans case, I hope they should have. They have told, the Supreme Court has written in the last paragraph, it's doing very well. 1,20,000 crores they have recovered without even filing case. Where is the data? There is no data. So you have to put facts before the Honorable Supreme Court so that they will come to. Now already money is gone. There is nothing is there for us. And then another 1 year, IBC will not function. Then, if IBC doesn't function, what are the implications? IBBA must have told the finance ministers. So therefore, this is a serious time required to look into the aspect of the key person, that is resolution professional, and then bring that to the notice of the Honorable Supreme Court and the ministry, so that the role of the, because in liquidation they have done well, because liquidator will be powerful. And he is entrusted with the responsibility, and his quasi judicial functions are there, and they have done all that. Let's not think on this. But the CIRP process is the intention of legislature is not liquidation. Even they wrote in that background paper that in the preamble itself there is no liquidation word. That means CIRP is the driven word. So this is what I want to. They must, one is include in this thing, bring the specific data of the, what do they, unbiased research that they have done. Because if you see most of the notifications and all of IBBI are basically are procedural in nature. That means all the top people, we don't know, we need to find from RTA. How many of them have industrial experience running enterprises? All these people are bureaucrats. Retired from various departments of the government. So they are always procedurally oriented. And they have to They have to know why this is not coming. Is there any white paper? Why went everything went for liquidation? What they could have done, they have not done. It's high time they come out of it. And this is what I am also going to present it before Honorable Madras High Court. That is why I am also going on discussing that to get better views.